This isn't just your normal program. You offer services, whoever will let them come. That's not what this is. This is really laser focused on the highest risk individuals. And second, it's really about developing a trusting and positive relationship. It's not just service brokering. It's not saying, hey, go get a job, or hey, let's see if we can find you some housing. That comes into place, but this is about building a trusting and positive relationship with these individuals, having intensive outreach with them, being relentless in their outreach, and helping these individuals make better decisions. And you do that with this positive and trusting relationship from someone who's coming from the community.
And this is, I know you guys have helped other cities like Oakland or whatever, but every city is slightly different, right? And I assume that's been taken into account in how we respond, right?
Absolutely. Several times during the training, I said, you know, here's the principles. Here's what we know is effective, but you've got to put your Indianapolis on, right? There's people from the community there. The good thing is the city has been piloting parts of this with smaller numbers of people. They've had 4 and 5 and 6. And so we've learned a bit from that about what types of approaches, the neighborhoods, how to approach some of the neighborhoods, how to find people. You know, an example of how this might work is there's two individuals who are in the same neighborhood group. One of those, and they're close. One of those individuals gets shot, and the other is now vowing revenge for that person's shooting. Often they're actually putting that on social media, so making it easier to figure out who we need to focus intervention on, although social media makes things worse as well. And so sometimes it's, how do we find that guy who's posting those vows of revenge on social media? Do we know somebody in that neighborhood? Do we know somebody in his family? Does somebody, some of the outreach workers actually know him from somewhere? And so a lot of that has an Indianapolis specific twist on it, of course.
And then lastly, I know you only have a few more minutes here, but the idea, it sounds like, is to, and this doesn't just happen in a vacuum. You've been studying, we looked at every victim, it sounds like, of gun violence or non-fatal shootings, and figured out sort of what are the causes of this, and then using that, this is really an analytical approach to figuring out how do we stop this. Is that fair?
That's absolutely right. This is a data-driven approach to reduce gun violence. So really understanding why shootings occur, who's involved in the shootings, identifying those individuals and applying intensive intervention with those individuals. Most shootings in Indianapolis are retaliatory shootings. It's a really bad retaliatory cycle. And so it's about mediating, intervening, and stopping that retaliatory cycle. And the good thing is we could identify about 70% of everyone who's going to be involved in a shooting prior to the shooting occurring. So if we can get ahead of it and have intensive intervention, we're going to be effective at reducing.